How many ways can you join your data without using traditional SQL joins? As SurrealDB is a multimodal database, it has different ways of joining data together. In this video, we'll cover the relational style joins. A semi-join is a subquery that filters the outer query with results of the inner query. Now that we got the dictionary definition out of the way, let's look at the code. As SurrealQL is a SQL-like language, you'll notice that the examples will look very similar. See if you can spot the single word difference in the queries. Since inner queries run before outer queries, it's often good to read the subqueries from the inside out. Starting with us filtering for products in the products table that have a price less than 20, then effectively joining the products table to the supplier table using the supplier ID. This then allows us to see the names of the suppliers which have products where the price is less than 20. The reason why you see the word value added to the select statement in SurrealQL is because by default, SurrealDB returns objects. Since we want to check if an ID is in an array of IDs, select value allows you to return an array of values instead. A key thing to notice here is that the entirety of the inner query is run before the outer query, which would make it an uncorrelated subquery. This does have some pros and cons, as we'll explore in our next example. A correlated subquery is still a subquery that filters the outer query with results of the inner query and is a type of semi-join. The key difference here is that the inner query can't run without the outer query, as you can see in the where statement. Where the defining characteristic of correlated subqueries is that it references a column in the outer query and executes a subquery once for each row in the outer query. Now, you might be wondering, why would we do that? There is a straightforward answer to that, and it is that it might be more performant. But as always, it depends. One of the reasons why this can be more performant is because we're limiting the range of possible records to scan to only those relevant to the outer query by using the where clause. In addition, we're adding limit 1 to the inner query since we're executing the subquery once for each row in the outer query. Therefore, we can further reduce the rows returned by the inner query. You'll also notice a difference in syntax here, where in SurrealQL, the exists is implicit, and we use a $parent parameter instead of directly naming parent table. Now with anti-joins, you're in for a surprise. No, just kidding. An anti-join is still a subquery that filters the outer query with the results of the inner query. The only difference is that it's the opposite of a semi-join. Instead of in, it's not in. And instead of exists, it's not exist. However, since SurrealDB doesn't use the exist word, you instead put an exclamation mark in front of the subquery to negate it like the not exist uses in the SQL example. Okay, enough with the subqueries. Let's look at how this compares to a normal SQL join. However, just to reiterate, the in, exist, and the left join example all give the same result. They just have a different way of getting there. The left join approach would probably be the initial approach most people would take. However, can you spot why it might be better to use a subquery approach we looked at previously? It's because the left join, we get duplicate results that we then need to deduplicate. This might be less performant than a subqueries, but again, it depends. SurrealDB does not do these typical joins, and one of the reasons is this unnecessary computation of getting more data than you need and spending even more computer resources on deduplicating or filtering the data back down to what you actually need. But that leaves a question. How would you do it instead in SurrealDB? One possibility is using record links. And as you can see in the SurrealQL example, things don't need to be complicated. This produces the same result as the semi-joins and the left join, but without any table scan at all due to how our record IDs work. If you can make relationships at write time, you can have peace of mind at query time that you're not going to get duplicate data that you then need to remember to deduplicate. That is, even if everyone who has access to this can remember to use the right join conditions to begin with. I hope this clears some of the fears of missing out or FOMO that you might have about SurrealDB not having traditional SQL joins. You can still do the things you need to do, such as with the subqueries. When it comes to the traditional joins, though, we think about it more in terms of the joy of missing out, or JOMO, because the best way to reduce errors in your code is by writing less code. That's all we have for you today. If you like this kind of content, make sure to like and subscribe, and tell us what you want to see next in the comments below.